We're in a new room. Welcome back, everyone. My name is Parker, and today we are going to be talking about the fisheye lens. Now, I have a great appreciation for fisheye lenses. They are one of my favorite lenses to actually play around with, and that's what I want to dedicate this video to is just why I love fisheye lenses and why you should too. I was originally going to call this video why they should bring back fisheye lenses in 2022, but, you know, we'll have to see because it's slowly starting to creep up that fisheye lenses are becoming more and more popular, but we'll get to that. We'll get to that in a little bit here. Let's talk about what a fisheye lens really is. I have some examples here as my more prevalent example is this Bauer 8mm f3.5 fisheye lens. This is a great little lens. This was one of my first ones. It has an aperture ring that allows me to change the aperture rings right on the lens. And this little guy is super fun to play around with. First time using it, I had so much fun taking photos with it. And that's what I really love about fisheye lenses is that you can be creative and different while also just having fun with them. Another example is this behemoth, this Canon 11-24mm f4. I don't know if you want to call it a fisheye or a wide angle lens because there is a cutoff when it's talking about fisheye and wide angle. And it's around, I would say, about 12-14mm. Hello everyone, this is Future Parker editing this video. I completely messed that up. A fisheye lens could even go up to 16-18mm. So that is on me, apologize for that. I mentioned that a few more times in this video, but just for clarification, it's 16-18mm.
But this actually is a great lens to have because it gives you a wide range, but you can tell a difference between the 11 and 24. 24 is definitely, you know, your basic shot. You're no longer really doing a wide shot. In this video right now, we're using a 24mm lens. Then you get to around the 11 to 14, you start to see a big difference. And that's when you start getting that kind of spherical effect. And that's what a fisheye lens is. It's ultra wide and it gives it that spherical effect. And it almost gives you a 180 degree view, which is great. I like it. It's so much fun to play with. Kind of the cutoff is here. I have another example is the 14mm, I would say. It still kind of has that spherical effect, but it's not as crazy as a normal fisheye. However, if you can see right now between this Bauer and this Rokinon 14mm that I have, they kind of look the same almost in a way. They have the same guard on it. It has that really bulbous lens. By the way, with these Rokinons, I plan on making a video. I have a whole set with that, so please look out for that. With these fisheye lenses, it allows you to see above, below, in front, and side to side of wherever your lens is looking. Fun fact, actually, the first mass-produced fisheye lens was made by Nikon back in 1957, and it had a huge price tag of $27,000. You can get these 8mm for around $100. I've actually seen this Bauer listed for $40 on Facebook Market. Now that you and I have a pretty good understanding of what a fisheye lens is, what are the uses? Like, what's even the point of using a fisheye lens? Well, in cinema, it's used kind of for distortion, kind of throws off the viewer a little bit. Or I've seen a lot of cases, somebody's really close up to like one of those door peak holes, and it's just like the super zoomed in on the nose or something like that. It's a lot of for comical effect, but you can also get some very serious wide shots, or you can see a lot with them, and that's mainly the point. The fisheye lens actually became very popular in the early 1960s, which is not too long after the first mass-produced lens was created by Nikon. It actually became very popular with the music industry. A lot of album covers like to use it. It was labeled as music's obsession. What it did is it made rock stars appear larger than life itself. And a great example of a band who used this was the Beatles. They started using the fisheye lenses quite a bit in the 1960s themselves. And as a recent, another example is Harry Styles' 2019 album, Fine Line. It was used to make him stand pretty tall. You can actually see the photographer's hand
in the shot. It's a really good picture. And those are just some examples of what the Fisheye lens has done in the music industry for album covers. A great video to actually watch to go a little bit deeper into the music history with Fisheye lenses is actually this video by Fox. I put the link in the description. I watched it. It's a great short video to kind of give you a nice timeline and just great examples of how the Fisheye lens has affected the music industry. It also became very popular, and this is when I started to really see the Fisheye lens, is with skating videos in the 1990s and early 2000s, and it was as recent, the early 2020s. What it did is it exaggerated their movement. It made an easier film line. It made it much easier to film the actual skate videos because you had such a wide view and you could see every part of the skater, and you could be trying to chase the skater down or trying to ride by them and you have a shaky camera, but you could still see the entire skater. Hence why the Fisheye lens became very popular with the skating community. It also just looked cool as f when somebody did a nice trick with the Fisheye lens. Now this brings me back to my original question, should the Fisheye lens make a comeback? With cinema, I think the way it is, I think it is fine. I believe it could be used more, but as it's coming back, lots and lots of more people have been actually using a cinema lens. And I would say without even knowing it, because with the new phones, like this iPhone 12, you have a cinema lens pretty much built into your phone. When you get the times 0.5 zoom, it just shoots it out. I'm seeing way more people use it. It creates a super funny effect on people, even when they're just joking around, but people also use it for great videos, and it's becoming extremely prevalent in with like memes and stuff on TikTok, like the that I love that because they use the Fisheye lens on that, or just skating in general, because skating is starting to slowly come back. It's always been kind of around, but it's becoming more popular as of today, or at least that's what I've been seeing. The Fisheye lens is just so fun, and I truly believe more people should give this lens more appreciation for what it truly is. It has made such a staple into today's life, but as I said, it does make things more funny and comical. You can also get really great pictures with a Fisheye lens. Like, here's some examples I'll show up on the screen. These are just some pictures I found off the internet that I really do enjoy and I think are really great pieces of art. Again, I understand this video was kind of all over the place. It was just really, I just wanted to explain my appreciation for Fisheye lenses. I love them. I believe they should be used more and they deserve way more appreciation than they have received. So if you have a Fisheye lens, go take some more pictures with it. Take some video, have some fun with it. You can even do it on your phone if you have one on a newer phone. Thanks for listening to my little rant. I hope you guys appreciate the video. If you have any questions or concerns, please leave them in the comments. I'll get right to them. But thanks for joining me on this video and I appreciate your time. Peace out.